Grashrak's Despoilers are a savage band of beasts of chaos who yearn for nothing more than the destruction of all civilization. And in this video, we're going to show you how to paint these miniatures by using Grashrak Fellhoof himself as our example. Now, even though we're going to be concentrating on this miniature, by following the methods and techniques we're going to show you, you'll be able to paint the entire warband. So, without further ado, let's get started. As with any Citadel miniature, the first stage of painting your models is to undercoat them, and for these miniatures we recommend Mechanica's Standard Grey Spray, which is a really good starting point for all the colours we're going to use, and you can see is exactly what I've sprayed my miniature with just here. Now to begin with, we're going to be concentrating on painting all of the flesh and all of the fur, and the first stage of doing this is to base coat all of that flesh by using Rakarth Flesh. Now as always, remember to give all of your paints a really good shake before you use each colour, and I'm going to be applying this using a medium base brush, which is a really nice size for the kind of area that we want to cover with at this stage. So throughout this video you'll see me using a palette, and I recommend you do the same thing. And to use a palette, what you do is just get a dollop of paint on your brush like this and just put it onto the palette there, because doing this allows you to thin it down with a touch of water. You don't need very much, just a little bit like that mixed in, because what this does is thins the paint down so it dries smoother, goes a bit further and gives you more control over it. So it's a really good habit to be in to do this. So once your paint is thinned down and your brush is loaded up, all you've got to do is start base coating all the flesh. And for this first stage, don't worry at all about being neat. Just look around the miniature carefully and spot all those areas of skin and make sure you base coat them entirely using this colour. Now once you've painted it on, you might see some of the grey undercoat showing through, which is not a problem. Just let that paint dry, then apply a second thin coat in exactly the same way before you move on to the next stage. With that base coat applied, we're now ready to move on to the next step, which is to give the skin some warmth by shading it. But for this, we're going to do something a little bit unusual to get to the skin tone of these miniatures, and that's to create our own shade by mixing Night Quest or Flesh with Lamia Medium. Now the reason why we're using Lamia Medium here instead of water is because what Lamia Medium is essentially shade with no pigment in it. So by mixing other paints with it, you create your own shades that will dry and act in the same way, resulting in a nice smooth finish to the skin. So to do this, what I'm going to do is use a medium shade brush, and all you've got to do is get a small amount of Night Quest or Flesh. So just a little brushful on there like that, and then just make sure your brush is nice and clean before you get any medium so you don't contaminate it with any colour. What I'm going to do is start out with a full brush load of this colour, or this paint, there we go, and then put it next to it and start mixing them together. And we're looking to get a very dilute version of the paint like this. You can see how thin and how runny it is there. So just make sure I haven't got my brush overloaded. There we go, they're loaded up. All you've got to do is start applying this over the skin, and you'll see it runs into the recessed detail and gives it a really nice smooth colour there like that. So all you need to do now is paint this all over the skin as before, not worrying about being neat, and once you've done so, give the miniature about 20 minutes to dry. With that mix dry, you can see the details are now becoming more defined, and we can now move on to the next step, which is to use Night Quest or Flesh on its own this time. I'm going to use a medium layer brush to apply it now for a little bit more control, and as with the Rakarth Flesh earlier on, I'm just going to add a touch of water to it to thin it down so it's nice and smooth. There we go. Now with this, what we're looking to do is to apply this over all the areas of flesh that we want to be darker, and also all the fur as well. So for example, the areas that are darker generally are things such as the nose, so I'm just going to paint a little bit up above there like that, and also towards the bottom of the legs. So what I'm going to do is just look at the texture of the muscles going down there, and just paint some of this colour following along that texture so it gets a little bit darker like that as we get close to the hoof. Then the other thing to look out for is the fur. For example, the fur just around here on the leg, just applies colour all over like this, just working it into the texture as you go. Once you've finished painting those features, we're now going to move on to the next colour, which is Gorthor Brown, which is going to be used to darken down that fur a little bit more, and also start painting all the wooden details in the miniature. Now I'm going to be using my medium layer brush to apply this once again, and it's going to be the same sort of technique as we did in the previous stage. So getting some of that paint onto your palette, then adding a touch of water to thin it down so it's nice and smooth, and then we're ready to start picking out these details. Now we've already darkened the fur a little bit with the Night Quest or Flesh, but now we just want to make it just that little bit darker. So this time we're looking at the textured areas only, just applying this colour over them like that, with a little bit of the Night Quest or Flesh just poking out the edge, just along there where it meets the flesh. Now also at this stage you want to look out for any wooden details, for example the staff we've got here, and base coat them with this colour at this stage. We're now ready to move on to the next phase, which is to lighten up and highlight that skin. And to do this, we're going to return to Rakarth Flesh first of all, and this time we're going to layer it onto the miniature. I'm going to use a medium layer brush to do this, and to get the paint ready, we do just like before, by getting some of this and putting it onto the palette and thinning it down with some water. But this time, we need to make sure that the brush isn't overloaded and that we've got a fine tip on it. And a great way of doing this is just to drag your brush along and twist it as you go like this, just to bring the bristles together. And there we go, we're now going to have lots of control over it. So what we want to do is to apply this to all the lighter areas of the flesh, but we're looking for the areas where the Night Quest or flesh is settled in the recesses and avoid them. So for example, on that area around the chest there and the neck, what I'm looking for is these flatter areas where I'm going to apply the paint like this. But you can see I'm leaving the Night Quest or flesh still showing in that recess down there and above that pec there as well where it meets the neck. So same on the other side, so just there like that. On the neck, you can see we've got that darker line down the middle there, so I'm just going to avoid that and paint on that side there. Then a little bit there like that. And there we go. So essentially what we're looking to do for this stage is to just repeat this process across the entire miniature. The only areas we're looking to avoid on the flesh are the things such as the nose that we want to keep darker. So I'm just going to paint the lip around there and leave the nose a little bit darker there. And also remember down the bottom of the legs where it goes towards the hoof, you want to leave that a little bit darker down there. So really all I'm going to do is layer down to around about there like that, just following the texture of the muscle. With that layer applied, all the muscles are now much more defined, and what we need to do is just to highlight them to finish them off. And for this, the colour we need is Pallid Witch Flesh, which I'm going to be applying using a small layer brush this time. And when you get this ready on your palette, what you should do is thin it down just a little bit more than you have been doing. So just get a little bit more water on your brush and mix that in. And the goal here is to make that paint a little bit transparent on your palette, so you can use that to check it. And here you go, you can see it's a little bit see-through on there, just about the right kind of consistency, just a little bit more water. And there we go. And as before, just get rid of the excess off your brush by just twisting it. And then what we're aiming to do is to paint this on the most defined features on the skin. So for example, on the face, that'd be areas such as around the lips. So I'm just going to paint a little bit on there and a little bit along there. We also want to pick out sharper points such as the ear. So just going to do a little bit going along there like that. When it comes to the hands, we're looking at things like the fingers and the thumbs. So for this, what you do is just paint a little bit of this color, just running along the fingers like that, just following along the raised area of that detail. And when you get to the back of the hands, you can see the tendons going back down towards the wrist. So for this, what we do is just follow those down very lightly like that, just being as neat as you can. You know, so I'm just drawing the brush downwards, painting towards myself, so I get nice straight lines. Now, when it comes to the smooth muscles, what we're wanting to do here is just to paint a little bit of this colour along the curvature where it catches the light the most. So for example, on the arms just here, what I do is just paint a little bit running along here, there like that. And then for the bicep, I'd just be painting a little bit following that curvature just there like that. So you see, it's always just really small amounts just to pick out that feature there like that. And with the skin now highlighted, we can move on to finishing off the fur. And to do this, what we're now going to do is paint over it with a contrast paint. We're going to use Black Templar to really darken it down, but still to allow some of that texture to show through. And to apply this, what you need is a medium layer brush, and you don't need to apply a lot of this, so use your palette just to make sure your brush isn't overloaded. So just get a little puddle of it there like this. Get rid of the excess paint, and then what we're looking to do is to just paint this purely over the fur. So, for example, if I look at this area just here, what I'm going to do is just paint it on to allow it to run into the recessed details and really darken it down. But I'm also always looking to paint it along the direction of the fur, and this way I get a rough edge towards it where it meets the skin like that, where you get some of that Night Quest or flesh still showing through to give you a nice transition from one texture to the other. Once the Black Templar is completely dry, you're then ready to finish off the fur by highlighting it using Carrick Stone. And to build on the texture of the fur, what we're going to do is dry brush this onto the miniature. To do this, you need a small dry brush, and what you do is just get a small amount of this paint onto the brush like this, then get some tissue and use it to work the paint into the bristles and also to get rid of the excess paint as well, so that you only have a very small amount left on there. You can always check it on the tissue paper just to make sure that, yes, see there's hardly any paint left on that brush now. And what you do is start drawing the brush lightly back and forth across the texture of the fur. But to really pick up on it, rather than going across the length of it, go against it. So we're going this way. See how the fur's going down? I'm going to be going sideways across it like that, just very lightly, just to get some of that colour catching the raised texture there like that. You don't need loads, just a small amount in the middle there, avoiding the flesh as best you can. And there we are, the fur is complete, and we just have one more little bit of detail left to add to the skin just to really finish it off, as this is the leader of the warband, so we're going to add just a little bit more detail to it. For this, what we need is Druki Violet, and what we're going to do is paint this around the mouth to add a little bit more colour there. You'll need a small amount, so I'm just using a small layer brush for this, and I'm going to be using the palette just to make sure I don't have too much of this on the brush. So less is more in a case like this, so just get rid of the excess. Now what we're going to do is just very lightly paint it around the mouth, just around here. So I'm just going to start there. Just add some of the colour running there like that. So you see it's a nice subtle effect, but it just brings a little bit more life to the miniature. And there we are. We've now painted in the skin and also the fur. And with that done, we can now base coat in the remaining details on the miniature. First of all, we're going to be using Corvus Black to base coat all the black details, followed by Dried Bark for all the dark brown details. After that, we'll need Doomball Brown for all the red leather, and then Zandri Dust for all the bone details. Finally, we need Mechanica Standard Grey, and this is for all the stone grey details, for example, the little trinkets around the miniature. But first of all, we need Corvus Black, and I'm going to be applying this with my medium layer brush again. And as before, use your palette to help get that paint ready by just adding a touch of water to the mix. Now, depending on which miniature you're painting, it does vary a little bit as to what parts exactly you paint black, but generally, you're looking mostly at leather details. For this particular miniature, you're looking at this kind of jacket that he's wearing, so around here, and just be really careful when you get close to those details that you've painted so far. But also, we've got these rags that are going over the top of his head, so around here. We also want to paint in the horns at this stage, so be sure to base coat all of these, going all the way down to the top of the scalp, just there. And for this miniature, we also have this sacrificial dagger, so we need to base coat the blade of this as well. Next, we're ready to paint the dark brown details using Dryad Bark. And for this miniature, that's things such as the leather straps, for example, the ones I've got running around here. But also at this stage, you want to base coat any twine on the miniature, such as the stuff around here, and also base coat the hooves as well. We're now ready to base coat any red leather details using Doomball Brown. For example, this red pouch that we've got around his belt. The next colour we need is Zandri Dust to base coat all the bone details. Now, there's quite a lot of these, and some of them quite small, and some are quite large. So for this stage, I like to use both a medium base brush and a medium layer brush, and just switch between them as you need to. And finally, neaten up any stone details using Mechanica's Standard Grey. Now, most of these are going to be small stone trinkets, for example, this one just here, and we've got this one here as well. But at this stage as well, you need to neaten up any stone that's on the base. Now, there's these larger rocks, for example, just here, but also be sure to neaten up the flat of the base as well. Once you've finished blocking in all those colours, you're ready to shade them all. And for this, we just need Agrax Earthshade, and I'm going to be applying it using a medium layer brush, because we only want to catch these new colours, avoiding all the flesh and all the fur. So use your palette to help control the paint, making sure your nut brush isn't overloaded, and then all you've got to do is start painting it onto these newer details. So for example, just around here, making sure you get a good amount to shade them all, but as you get close to that flesh and the fur, just be really careful so as not to run onto it. Now at this stage, one small detail to make sure you say that isn't one of these new colours is the inside of the mouth, because you just need to darken this down. So just be as neat as you can and just run some shade into that area like this. The shade is now completely dry, and you can see it's given lots of depth to all those details. And now we're ready to move on to the next phase, which is to highlight all those details and really make them stand out. Now to do this, first of all, we're going to start out by highlighting all the black details. So these are things like the knife blade, the black leather, and also the horns. And for this, first of all, we need Skaven Blight Dinge, followed by Storm Vermin Fur. Now I'm going to start out with Skaven Blight Dinge, and I'm going to be applying this using a small airbrush. And we don't need very much of this, but still use your palette to make sure the paint's at the right consistency. So put a bit on your palette and add a touch of water to it. And there we go, mix that together, and then get rid of the excess paint by just twisting your brush like that on the palette, bringing those bristles to a nice point. And then what we're aiming to do is to pick out all the edges and sharper details on the black features on the miniature. So for example, we've got this kind of jacket that he's wearing. What you want to do first of all is follow the edge all the way around. So just very delicately paint a line of this colour, just going all the way around the outside there like that. And if you look carefully, I'm actually using the side of my brush rather than the tip, just gently running it across that sharp edge at the edge of the clothes there, like that. Now also we're looking for features that stand out, such as creases, and you can see there's a crease just above this brown leather strap we've got there, so you'd also want to paint a bit of this colour just following along there like that. This time using the tip and just bracing my hands to be as steady as possible. Now we also need to do the knife blade at this stage, and for this, as with the clothing, we want to follow along all the raised ridges, and you can see there's quite a lot of texture running all the way down. So just use the side of your brush first of all to go across the edge of the blade there, and then follow those lines just back towards the middle, just with quick flicks of your brush like this. And the final thing to highlight at this stage is the horns, and for these what we want to do is make them a little bit lighter towards the base. So to begin with, you can see there's these ridges going all the way up the length of them. So use the side of your brush just to follow all the way up to the top there like that, and then the lines going across the side of the horns, what we want to do is to paint along those but much closer together towards the base, gradually getting further and further apart as we go further up like that. And this gives the illusion of the colour getting lighter towards the bottom where there are more of those lines. Once you've finished applying that highlight, you can move on to Storm Vermin Fur. And for this, we're going to follow the same sort of technique, only being a little bit more selective about where to highlight. We're looking for sharper details. So for example, this crease we've got on the fabric here, just a little bit of this colour just here where it stands out a little bit more, just to exaggerate that detail there like that. So again, on the edges of things, we're looking for where the light would catch, which is at the top around the shoulders, so just a little bit there like that. On the horns, we're following the same sort of technique as what we did previously, only this time focusing those lines towards the base of the horns just a little bit further down. So I'm doing lines just around there, then leaving it and starting to space out much sooner than we did with the previous stage to increase that light colour towards the base of the horns there like that. On the knife blade, once again, you want to highlight the edges, but really focus it this time along the actual edge of the blade where it would be sharper. Now that we've highlighted those details, we can move on to highlighting some other ones. And first of all, what we're going to use is Administratum Grey to add a very fine highlight to the horns and also the knife blade, but also we're going to dry brush this colour onto the miniature for all the stone detail. After that, we'll need Tusk or Fur to highlight all the red leather, and then Gorthor Brown for the dark brown leather, followed by Baneblade Brown, which we're going to be using on the wooden details. But first of all, we need Administratum Grey, and there's two phases to applying this. First of all, using your small layer brush, we're going to do a fine highlighting, just like we did previously. So get some of that paint onto the palette and thin down, as you normally do, and then get rid of the excess paint so that you've got a really fine tip on your brush. And then what we're aiming to do here is to just finish off the horns with a very few fine lines at the base of them, just like how we've been doing, just a few lines down here, there like that, just to give that illusion of them getting lighter the further down you get there, you see, and then getting darker the further up you go. On the knife, we just want to give that little appearance of sharpness by just adding small amounts of this colour just on the very edges of these points here. So you see we've got these little points going all the way down the blade. We just want to pick those out with a little bit of this colour like this. And once you've finished doing that, we're ready to highlight all the stone details. And for this, what we need to do is to dry brush the colour on. So now I'm going to switch to a small dry brush and we just need to get a little bit of this paint ready. So normal dry brushing procedure here. Just a little bit of that paint onto your brush, get some tissue, work it into the bristles like that and get rid of the excess paint. And once you've done so, what you need to do is start looking out for all the stone detail. And there's small trinkets, but of course also stone on the base. So for this, all you gotta do is just lightly start dry brushing against it like that, just to pick out the raised details and edges so they stand out. And when you get to the trinkets on the miniature, for these, all you gotta do is just be as neat as you can. Just be very selective about dry brushing just in these parts and just try to focus that color just onto the stone there like that. We can now highlight all the red leather, and for this we need Tusk or Fur. So still using a small airbrush, once more just follow along all those sharper edges and details. With that done, we can now move on to highlighting all the dark brown leather. For this we need Gorthor Brown, still using the small airbrush, once again just follow along all the sharpest edges and details. And finally, we're ready to highlight all the wooden details by dry brushing them using Baneblade Brown, and this will really bring out the texture of these details. With those colours highlighted, we've actually very nearly finished. We just have one more major area to finish off before finishing off just some very minor details. And that larger area is to finish all the bone detail. Now for this, what we're going to do is layer all the bones first of all using a shabty bone, and then we're going to highlight them using Pallid Witch Flesh. But first of all, we need a shabty bone, which I'm going to be applying with a medium layer brush. And for this technique, what we're aiming to do here is to paint this colour over most of the bone, but leaving the recesses still with that darker shade showing in them. So use your palette, as always, to get that paint nice and smooth and under control. Get rid of the excess paint, and then I'll show you what I mean on one of the skulls on the miniature. So if we take a look at this one that we've got just on the front here, what I'm going to do is look for the flatter surfaces and apply this colour to them. So the forehead, for example, there like that. But you can see how I'm not going all the way into that recess where that shade is settled. I want to leave that darker, skip that area, and then move just beyond it like that. So this way I'm keeping the definition from the shade, but exaggerating the raised areas to make them stand out more. So what you need to do now is just carry on doing this on all the bone, just taking your time and being as neat as you can. And once you've finished applying that layer, you can then highlight all the bone using Pallid Witch Flesh with your small layer brush. And for this, as before, what you're doing is just following along all those edges, the bits that stand out. So for example, in this skull here, you can see I'm going around the eye sockets, and I'm also picking out the cheekbones there like that, around the little ridge going around the nose there. And of course, we need to do the teeth as well. Now, when it comes to the miniature's face as well, we also need to paint the teeth up here. So for this, just be as steady as you can and just pick out the raised details as neatly as possible like this. And there we are, the bone is fully painted and this miniature now looks like it's almost complete. There's just a few little things left to do to finish it off. And the first of these is to get some Screamer Pink to paint in the tongue, then some Athonian Camouche to add onto the base to give it more of a mossy appearance. And then finally we just need some blood for the Blood God to paint the blood that's on his dagger. But first of all we need Screamer Pink, and I'm going to use a small airbrush for this. And for this you just need a small amount of this paint, which you should water down a fair amount so it's nice and thin. There we go. And then once you've got it nicely diluted like that, all you need to do is just be as neat as you can in painting this over the tongs. Just hold your hands as steady as possible to be careful not to get this colour on the teeth. So there we go, just a small amount like that. With that tongue complete, we're now ready to paint the base using a Thonian camo shade to make it look a little bit more mossy. And for this, what we're aiming for is to paint the texture around the ground like this, just being careful of the rocks and the bones. And with the base now complete, all that remains to do is to paint some blood for the blood god over the blood drips on the knife to give a really nice dark blood effect. Now, once you've done this, all you need to do is paint the rim of the base of the miniature. And for this model, I'm going to use a Baden black, but of course the colour you use is entirely up to you. And with that rim of the base fully painted, Grashrak is now complete, ready to lead his despoilers in tearing down all civilization. So when you're painting this miniature, there's a few things to bear in mind. The first is that when you're shading the skin, be sure to dilute the paint using Larmian medium rather than water to ensure a nice smooth finish. Then later on, when you're applying shade paint to all the detail after the skin and the fur, be sure to use the correct size brush to make sure that you don't overdo it and catch that shade onto details where you don't want it. And finally, when you're applying your highlights, always remember to be as neat as you can, because as always, the neater you are, the better the final result is going to be. But by following the methods and techniques we've shown you in this video, you'll be able to paint the entire warband, so we really hope that you have fun when you're painting your models, and we'll see you all again very soon.